It's time, as Nancy said, for America to just say no to drugs.
So, won't you join us in this great new national crusade?
God bless you, and good night.
We're back. That was, of course, the famous anti-drug message from President Reagan in the 1980s. But with Colorado and Washington State actually legalizing marijuana for recreational use, attitudes have clearly shifted in this country. Well, now President Obama himself has weighed in on the issue. Here's what he had to say in a profile piece by David Remnick in the latest New Yorker. Quote, as has been well documented, I smoked pot as a kid. This is the president speaking. And I view it as a bad habit and a vice, but very different from the cigarettes, but not very different from the cigarettes that I smoked as a young person up through a big chunk of my adult life. I don't think it is more dangerous than alcohol. Well, it's a departure from what we've heard from administrations in the past, but the president offered this by way of explanation. Quote, middle-class kids don't get locked up for smoking pot, and poor kids do, and African-American kids do, and Latino kids are more likely to be poor and less likely to have the resources and the support to avoid unduly harsh penalties. Well, they're better lawyered the way kids are. Anyway, joining me now is the author of What Addicts Know, a friend of mine, Chris Kennedy, Christopher Kennedy Lawford, and his cousin, who also joins us, former U.S. Congressman from Rhode Island, Patrick Kennedy, there he is, who heads up the Smart Approaches to Marijuana Project. I generally support the president a lot of things. I mean, I'm famous for that or whatever, infamous for that. But the fact is, I don't think he's right on this one, because I think people have addictive personalities and some people react to freedom differently than others. And let me go to Patrick Kennedy on this. It seems to me we all deal with our anecdotal experiences in life. I mean, that's how you talk from experience.
Right.
I'm hung around guys that drank too much, and after they drank too much, would go look for dope around midnight. And so don't tell me booze wasn't a gateway to dope or to marijuana. And I don't have that much experience with the other stuff, but I do have that concern about the gateway issue. Your thoughts?
So first, Chris, you hit the nail on the head. Most of us know about this issue anecdotally. So what we need, Chris, is we need to know what the science tells us, the science of public health. So I think the president needs to speak to his NIH director in charge of drug abuse, Nora Volkow, because the NIDA director, Nora Volkow, would tell the president that, in fact, today's modern genetically modified marijuana, so it's much higher THC levels, far surpassed the marijuana the president acknowledges smoking when he was a young person, so that he is wrong when he says that it isn't very harmful, because the new marijuana is not the old marijuana. And, of course, the president is making this decision based upon his anecdotal experience. We need to have presidential decisions made based upon public health and the sound science that the federal government is invested in, which shows that this is very harmful. In fact, Chris, as my cousin Chris just mentioned, if it's legalized, we know rates of use will increase, availability will increase, and accessibility. And as you know, Chris, if you have a predisposition to addiction, this is going to be a gateway. And frankly, Chris, it's a harmful drug in and of itself. Like, I was lucky, Chris. I got in and crashed early because I used harder drugs. Marijuana is insidious. You could be using it for most of your life and not wake up to the fact that you're on a slow train to nowhere. And that's the damaging part about marijuana for our country.
Well, Corey, let me show the latest poll.